A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. My respected brothers and my sisters, today I'm going to have a little reflection about one of the most important things from the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in 23 years of short time had given us a concept of ummah. This concept of ummah is a very unique concept. You will not find this concept throughout human history in any other nation but Muslims. That when you accept Islam, when you utter this kalma, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, you become part of this bigger family, Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No matter which country you belong to, no matter what language you speak, no matter what social status you have, but you all become brothers and sisters. That's why we call each other brother and sister. You will not see any other religion, Judaism or Christianity. You can go through all different religions. Nobody calls each other brother and sister. In 23 years of life of Prophet Muhammad, he developed this mawakhat. He developed this concept of ummah. That yes, for our introduction, for our identity, if I identify myself with one country, one tribal area, one community, there is nothing wrong in that. But my pride is not in my connection with my community, with my tribe, with my country. Rather, my pride is in my relationship, in my connection with Islam, part of Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the ultimate introduction. That is the ultimate identity that I want to connect myself with. My brothers and my sisters, look at the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Here comes Suhaib Rumi. He is not Arab. Salman Farsi radiallahu ta'ala anho, about whom Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he is from my al. Look at Hazrat Bilal Habshi radiallahu ta'ala anho, from Habsha. But look what status Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had given him after Fateh Makkah. He reaches to Kaaba, who he calls to go on the top of Kaaba and give azan. Not any other Quraysh sahabi, not any Arab sahabi. Rather, he calls Bilal Habshi radiallahu ta'ala anhu to go on top of Kaaba and give azan. My brothers and my sisters, look at this concept of ummah. This is same Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu about whom Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, when I went on Miraj, I heard the sound of steps of somebody in front of me. And I asked Jibreel alayhi salam, who is he walking in front of me that I can hear the sound of his steps? Jibreel alayhi salam said, this is Bilal. Look at Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what community he has developed. That there, the status given to everybody as a Muslim was equal, regardless of their social status, regardless of their color, regardless of their geographical boundaries, regardless of their tribal affiliation. I will give here example of Hazrat Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And we all know Hazrat Julaybib, he was, nobody knew about his tribe, nobody knew his tribal affiliation. He did not have any social status in the community. His facial features were such that nobody wanted to give their daughter to him because of his appearance, because of his social status. But look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After Julaybib has become Muslim, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him one day in the shopping place and asked Julaybib, Julaybib, did you get married? Julaybib said, who is going to give me his daughter, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes himself with the proposal of marriage for Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In one of the battles, when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Sahaba, have you counted everybody? And they said, yes. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I don't see Julaybib. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes himself and tries to find Julebib, and he finds his dead body mutilated. He picks up Julebib with his own hands and brings him and buries him and puts him down in grave with his own blessed hands. And then says the famous words about Julebib that nobody want to have any affiliation with. Had no social status. But because he was part of this ummah, after saying kalma la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, Prophet says Julebib is from me and I am from Julebib, my brothers and my sisters. So this unique concept of ummah is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you and me. Today, our enemies wants to create division among Muslims. That this is Saudi, this is Pakistani, this is Turkish. Nothing wrong just for introduction. But my pride is not I am Pakistani or I am Saudi. My pride lies that I am part of the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We have to keep this concept of Ummah alive. We had this concept up until the fall of Ottoman Empire. Up until that time, even if the Khilafa was weak, but still every Muslim on this earth had this connection with Ummah concept. That's why when Ottoman Empire was falling, even India was not part of Ottoman Empire, but still you can see the Muslims of India collected gold. The mother of Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar and Shaukat Ali Johar, she collected all this gold to support. She knew that this gold is not going to make a difference, but she wanted to become from the people that who have done their best to protect, to save Khilafah. My brothers and my sisters, save this concept of Ummah to support Ottoman Empire. She sends the gold which you still can find in the treasury of Turkey, and that's why Turkish people, they love Muslims from India and Pakistan. Because of this, you know, sacrifice they had made, my brothers and my sisters. So we really, as a Muslim, should do our best to keep this concept of Ummah alive. That every Muslim brother and sister, does not matter, belongs to any country, is my brother, is my sister. And you know, I lived in Jordan for 2 years with my family. Wallahi, I did not have any family member in Jordan, but not even for a single second my family felt like they are alien in that country or they are foreigner in that country. Rather, everybody was so welcoming. Then whenever we used to go and travel all around the country, everybody was so helpful that sometimes they used to give us so much discount on everything, like they want to give everything free to us. Respect, waqar, ikram for each other, that is part of this concept of Ummah, my brothers and my sisters. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He keeps this spirit of Ummah in us so that we all can stay as bunyanum marsus, as solid wall with akhwa and love for each other, so we can show that as an example for the rest of the world. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الله